In this video, we're gonna see how to upgrade this mini PC, the ThinkCentre M900 to be exact, and later install Proxmox to use it as a home server. I got this for about $100 on eBay, which I think is pretty good deal on this one little PC. So for the upgrade, I'm gonna go with the 1TB hard drive. I'll also add the 8GB DDR4 RAM. And an old SSD that I took from my laptop. It's a 500GB SSD. So let's open it first. We just need to unscrew this one little screw, and then we just slide it. So this is how it looks inside. First, we need to remove the HDD hard drive bay to get access to the RAM slots and the SSD. We just need to remove the screw and carefully remove the bay because it's attached to the Wi-Fi antenna. There we go. There is already an 8GB RAM, so we need to add another 8 to for a total of 16GB. This is useful for especially to run virtual machines. Next, we're gonna remove the SSD. It came in with 256, but it's not enough for me, so I'll just upgrade it to 512. Now I'm gonna put back the drive bay. Also, you need to attach the Wi-Fi antenna back and put back the screw, of course. Now I'll just add the hard drive. It's a 1TB hard drive. I need it for Proxmox. That's it, we're done. Let's put it back together now. And then we're gonna plug it to the PC, to the monitor, and continue from there. I'm gonna boot to the BIOS first. I want to make sure everything is correctly detected. And then also to check some settings. As you can see, we have 16GB of RAM. SSD is detected as well as the hard drive. Virtualization is enabled, that's good. Everything is enabled. I guess I don't have to enable anything. That's it, everything looks good. Now let's boot to the USB, to the Ventor USB, which has a Proxmox on it. I will not go in details for the installation in this video because I'm gonna cover Proxmox in a later video. So just 2 minutes to make sure everything is working perfectly. So this is the installation. I'm gonna leave everything by default for now. I'm gonna choose password. Interface is correct. For Proxmox, we need to set a static IP. It doesn't use DHCP here. So I'm just gonna choose an IP. For me, it's 200 because it's not used by any other device. That's it, and we launch the installation. It's gonna take some time. That's it, Proxmox is correctly installed now. Let me know in the comments if you want me to make a video specially about Proxmox and how to set it up. Don't forget to like and subscribe, of course.